Dear students, we will continue with the module 2. In this lecture video, we will be studying the specification of tokens. So, what are the different specification of tokens, rules on tokens are there that we are going to study. So, regular expression is an important notation for specifying patterns of tokens. So, pattern of token will be expressed in the form of regular expressions. So, before studying, we should understand few terms with respect to regular expression. So, let us see string and language. First of all, we will be studying in string and languages. So first let us see the alphabet. What is alphabet? It is a finite set of symbols. It is a finite set of symbols. Example of symbols are letter. It can be letters, it can be digits, or it can be punctuations. For example, let us see 0 and 1. It is a set of two letters. It is a set of two digits. Is a binary alphabet and it is called binary alphabet. Then string or next one is string or sentence or word. What is it? It is a finite sequence of symbols drawn from that alphabet. It is a finite sequence of symbols drawn from that alphabet. Length of then what is the length of the string? Number of occurrences of symbol in string. For example, let us see symbol compiler. String compiler. So how many letters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8. So length of string is 8. Then another thing we have we can see that empty string. So it is a special string of length 0. It has 0 length. Then language, any countable set of strings over some fixed alphabet. It is any countable set of strings over some fixed alphabet is called language. For example, the set of all strings of 0 or more is over an alphabet A. So it can be for example, suppose alphabet A is there. Then what will be language? It can be defined as null set, or it can be A, it can be AA, or it can be AAA. So together the set it is called language. Next, empty set. The set containing only the empty string. The set containing only the empty string, it is called the empty set, and it will be represented as epsilon, set epsilon. Now, terms of parts of string. Let us see prefix of S. Prefix of symbol. What is prefix of symbol? It is a string obtained by removing zero or more symbols from the end of S. So, for example, suppose we have a banana. So ban is the prefix of symbol banana. A string obtained by removing zero or more symbols from the end. From the end, if we remove ANA, then what will be left? It is BAN. So BAN or epsilon is the prefix of banana. Similarly, suffix of S. It is a string obtained by removing zero or more symbol from the beginning of S. From the beginning of S, if you remove, then what is left, that is called suffix of symbol. So, for example, let us see BA. If you remove BA, in what is left? NANA. So NANA, banana, epsilon are suffix of banana. So banana itself, it can be suffix of A. Why? If you are removing epsilon, I mean nothing if you remove, then what is the suffix left? Banana itself. Or if completely if you remove, what is the suffix left? It is a epsilon. So this all can be a suffix of S. Similarly, substring of S, a string obtained by deleting any prefix and any suffix from S. Suppose for example, here it can be NANA or BAN or epsilon or substring of banana. Then proper suffixes or prefixes and substring of S. So those are prefix, suffix and substring only, but except epsilon and S. Except epsilon and S, if it is considered as prefix, suffix, prefix and substring, then it will be called proper suffix. Here in the prefix, even epsilon it is there. Epsilon can be prefix of banana. And banana itself it is a, or S itself it is a prefix of S. So if you remove epsilon and S, it is called proper suffix or proper prefix or proper substring. Then sequence of S, any string formed by deleting zero or more, not necessarily consecutive position of S, it is called sequence of S. So for example, B double A N is the subsequence of banana. B double A N, it is subsequence of banana. Now what are the different operations on language we can find? Suppose union of L and M. So LUM, it is the symbol notation, it is LUM. So it is a set of S such that S is in L or S can be in M also. Then intersection of L and M, L intersection M is a set of S such that S is in L and S is in M also. Then concatenation of L and M, L M is equal to S T such that S is in L and T is in M. It is a very simple, it is all equal to the, it's a very similar to the set which we had studied in our first PUC mathematics. Next is regular expression. So regular expression is any well-formed formula constructed over union or concatenation and closure. So regular expressions are important notation for specifying patterns. It is a regular using the regular expression we can notify the pattern. The regular expressions are built recursively out of smaller regular expressions using a set of defining rules. Regular expressions are built recursively out of smaller regular expressions using a set of, for example, let us see, each regular expression R denotes the language L of R. Suppose if R it is a regular expression, then language defined is L of R. So rules that define the regular expression over an alphabet are, there are two rules, basis rules. So in this one, there are two rules that form the basic. If epsilon is a regular expression, then L of epsilon is null set. That is the set containing the empty string. And if A is a symbol in set, then A is a regular expression and L of A equal to set A. That is the language with one string A. Then induction. There are four rules for the deriving larger regular expressions for a smaller one. Suppose R and S is a regular expression denoting L of R and L of S as language. Then R bar S is a regular expression denoting the language L of R union L of S. R S